Hello, my name is Katie and I'm one of your Blackpool and the Fylde College School Liaison Officers. And today I am here with Nicole Dean, our Programme Leader for Engineering. And today we're going to have a closer look at this curriculum area and hopefully answer any questions that prospective students might have. So hello, Nicole.
Hi, Katie.
How are you today?
Very good, thanks. You?
Yeah, great. Thank you for joining me. So obviously, at Blackpool and the Fylde College, all of our tutors are industry specialists within their field and come from the industry. So we'll just start with you giving us a bit about your background, really. So what you did before you come here as a Blackpool and the Fylde College tutor.
So my background's a little bit different to everybody else in the engineering department. I have a science background.
Okay.
Within medical science. So I've worked within the NHS. I've worked with a little bit in the private sector as well. And again, my colleagues have been the same. So they may have worked for government organisations or in the engineering industry within the private sector too. So yeah, we've got a real broad mix of different skills and different backgrounds.
Fantastic. So how has it been being a female in the engineering industry? Because obviously some students might think that it's a traditionally a male-dominated subject. So what would you say to those prospective students out there that are females and maybe considering engineering as a course?
It does definitely come across as very male-dominated. Particularly within our department, we're almost at a 50-50 split now with males and females. Our programme leaders, 4 out of the 6 are actually females now, so we're slowly taking over. But I think the perspective of, you know, potential females that are interested in that, it's quite a dirty, hands-on job. And I think we need to slowly move away from that. With it being such a broad, broad subject, we have things like quality, project management, and girls can get stuck in there and we can do all the practical. And we do tend to find that our female students do perform better in those kind of areas. So it's just moving away from those kind of stereotypes and thinking females can do this. We can, you know, take those higher paid jobs. We can become managers within engineering. And I'd just say, just go for it. Doesn't matter if we work with men, so what? We can show them that we can do it too, so.
Fantastic, and obviously you're an amazing role model for our current female students that we have here, so that's really great to hear that insight from you and the experiences that you've had within engineering. So looking more in terms of the actual curriculum area itself, so engineering is quite a broad term.
Yeah.
So for students out there that are not quite sure what engineering is, can you just give us a kind of simple, generic example of what engineering is?
So as a whole, basically engineering is using scientific principles and mathematical principles to design and build structures. So we do general engineering, which focuses on all aspects, and then we have the option to specialise into different areas. Those might be mechanical, electrical, aerospace, industrial, mechatronics. So our mechanical focuses on that design and analysis aspect and the manufacturing side of things. Electrical, very, very similar, but using electronic devices, circuits, electromagnetism. Mechatronics is a little bit of a combination of both. So we've got a little bit of mechanical in there, a little bit of electrical in there, and we focus a lot on robotics too.
Okay.
Something that's quite new to us also is industrial engineering. That's a little bit more of a step back from the practical side of things, and it's looking at all the processes and that optimization process to actually streamline. It might be a project, you might be looking at a quality cycle, you might be looking at cost effectiveness. So industrial engineering is essentially streamlining everything involved within an engineering business.
Fantastic. So obviously you went into a bit more detail about the different specialisms we have within the engineering department. Am I right in saying that we have a welding course here as well?
Yeah, so welding is part of that manufacturing process. It's quite a new course to us that we're now running as a full-time course. Particularly for the local area, we have a lot of manufacturing and fabrication businesses. So there's definitely the careers out there, and this is what we've seen. So we've developed this course for those students to be able to actually work in the local area and fill those roles for that local need.
Fantastic. So obviously we're sat in our amazing ATC, which is our Advanced Technology Centre, and we do pride ourselves at Blackpool and the Fylde College for having industry standard facilities and equipment. So can you give us a few examples of the high-tech equipment we have in our ATC that students can use?
So we've got industry standard robots, which are part of our mechatronics courses. So students will actually learn how to program those robots. It might be things that you see maybe in films where they're building cars and you see the robotic arms. That's what we actually use here. So if they use it in industry, we're training the students to work on what we'd actually been using there. We have CNC machines, we've got lathes, We've got hydraulics, pneumatics. It's basically, if we think they're going to be going out into the world of work using that equipment, we want them to use the equipment here with us. So as much as we can, you know, we're trying to invest in the latest products, the latest software packages. Simulation tools is another one. So if they choose to go into mechatronics and they're going to be doing a lot of simulations in industry, we have the industry simulation packages as well that they'll be working on for the programming. So if it's in industry, we want it, and you know, we try to use that as much as we possibly can.
It's fantastic, and being in here and seeing it for myself, it's such an amazing building. And our ATC is home to all of our courses for engineering, isn't it?
Yeah.
So every single course that's to do with engineering would be based here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Fantastic. So moving on from this, obviously we've mentioned about the industry standard facilities that we have linking to the employers. What sort of careers can our engineering students look forward to going into?
So a popular choice at the moment, and obviously with British Aerospace being just down the road, we have a lot of students on our aerospace pathway. So they might go on to be project managers within aerospace. They might go on to be aircraft technicians. They might go in within the RAF, doing weapons engineering in the Navy. If we look, we've got a lot of fabrication industries locally, and that is something that a lot of our students, particularly those that are studying the welding with us at the moment, are going into. It's just such a kind of a broad industry. For the ones that have recently graduated, they're working in project management within engineering on some very high-level government projects, very, very big, expensive projects too. So, you know, they're straight out there into industry.
Fantastic. And obviously, as part of all of our courses here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, all of our students have a planned industry placement.
Yeah.
So they'd go out to the employers in the local areas and do a placement with them. So obviously, BAE being on our doorstep, we have a strong local link with them. But what other kind of links do we have with local employers, national employers, that our students can look forward to doing their work experiences with those people?
So we've really strong links with Springfield Fuels, Westinghouse. A little bit more locally, we have Blackpool Transport, the Heritage Trams, the Illuminations. So the students are directly getting involved in places that are, you know, helping towards the economy as well.
Fabulous.
Redwood Engineering, who specialise in re-engineering older automotive vehicles and making them more useful for actually roadworthy now.
Oh,
so
wow.
You might have something that's, say, 100 years old, that they're essentially bringing it back to life. We have people in the manufacturing, so at Fox's Biscuits, at Burton's Biscuits. So not just the food side of things,
yeah,
but actually involved in all the manufacturing processes as well.
Fabulous. So obviously with them work experiences and with that chance to work with such great employers, do our courses kind of, can students go straight from doing one of our engineering courses straight into employment, or would they go to a degree? What is the kind of progression route
so
for them?
Several different routes. For engineering, we start right down at level two, which is the equivalent of GCSE level. There is then the option to progress all the way through to level three, level four, five and six. So to come out with a Bachelor's of Engineering. At any point, a student could go out into industry and start within the engineering industry. So if we're level two, level three, they're going to be those lower end jobs, but they are skilled enough to take those straight out into industry. Obviously, we would say to our students, progress all the way through, give yourselves the best opportunity. Our employment rate from the degrees is very, very high. We have some students that have gone into some absolutely amazing jobs out within industry. So there's always progression points throughout, but there's always that chance to get yourself out into industry for a little bit. We do have some students that will finish at level three, they'll go to work for a little bit, a few years later they will come back to us to progress so that it allows them to progress at work as well.
And obviously as well, meaning kind of carrying on from that, all of our degrees are also, in terms of engineering, everything's based here, isn't it, at the ATC?
All the facilities are available to all students. We especially enjoy having our degree students here, and it's something they like to actually get hands-on with the facilities that they'll use. We have quite a few students who are already in industry that come to us to do our degrees. So BAE Systems send quite a lot of their students to us. Again, Westinghouse send many of their students to us to complete the degree whilst they're still at work too. So the employers are recognising, you know, the benefits of having this higher level of study and the quality that they're getting from that degree.
That's great. Well, thank you so much for your time today, Nicole. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you, Katie.
So if you would like to find out any more information about any of our engineering courses here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, then please visit our website. You can also find our online prospectus on there as well, and that's easily downloadable. And of course, if you are interested in applying for any of our engineering courses that we've spoke about today, then you can go on our website, find your desired course, and click the apply button. Thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.